Welcome to EPG Pathshala. Today we are going to understand the topic on characteristics of medical film and dry imaging camera. Under this topic, we will try to understand what is a medical film, what is its structure and what is its function. We will also try to understand how an image is formed on a medical film. We will also try to look into what are the characteristics of the medical film, what is meant by the different shades of grey and the density produced on the film. Now let us try to understand this subject in detail. Medical film is basically a negative image recorder. It is used to acquire the image. The image that is acquired is further processed and is made visible. And the same film, when is developed, is used for image storage. The medical film is available in number of sizes. It is available from the size of 8 by 10 inches to the size of 14 by 17 inches. The concept of medical film, how an image is processed and how the image is made visible, is shown in the figure. The different shades of gray produced on the film and how does it vary with the amount of exposure is also shown on the screen. Now the different shades of gray are basically nothing but the film density. So the film density is the amount of overall blackness produced on the processed image. A radiographic film, as has been mentioned, is a negative recorder, which means that the developed film becomes darker with the increase in light or X-ray. The degree of darkness of the film is quantified by the term optical density. It is written as OD and can be measured with a densitometer. Now, how do we define optical density? Optical density is defined as the logarithm of the ratio of the incident light intensity on the film to the light intensity transmitted through the film. The formula for the optical density is given as log to the base 10 to the ratio of I naught by IT, where I naught is, as mentioned, the incident light intensity and IT is the transmitted intensity. The ratio of the transmitted intensity and the incident light intensity is called the transmittance. The same is explained in the adjoining figure, where it is mentioned that the incident light photons, if they were 100% incident on the screen, after passing through the film, only 1% is transmitted. So accordingly, optical density can be calculated. This particular slide shows the percentage of light transmittance and calculated optical densities. It can be seen that the films that transmit 10% and 1% of the incident light have optical density of 1 and 2 respectively. How do we measure the optical density? The instrument that is used to measure the optical density is densitometer. The figure of densitometer is shown on the screen. A densitometer contains a source of white light. This light source shines a small beam onto one side of the developed film and electronically measures the amount of light reaching the other side. Densitometer has a small aperture, approximately 3 mm diameter, that measures the optical density, and this corresponds to this 3 mm diameter of the aperture. Now, how does a film look like? What is the structure and composition of the film? A film is basically composed of a layer of emulsion coated on one or both sides of a transparent polyester plastic base, also known as mylar. The emulsion is attached to the polyester base by a thin layer of transparent adhesive. The soft emulsion layer is covered by a supercoat of hard gelatin. The typical cross-section of a radiographic film is shown on the screen. The film has a base. This base is used to provide support to the emulsion, and the typical thickness of the base of the film is 150 to 200 micrometer. The emulsion is the only active component in which the image is formed. It is made up of silver halide crystals that are uniformly distributed in clear gelatin. The gelatin holds and protects the silver halide crystals. It distributes the silver halide crystals uniformly over the base. The thickness of emulsion is approximately 10 micrometer. Now the image that is formed on the film is latent image, which is further processed to make it visible. Now what is meant by the latent image? Latent image refers to that image that exists on film after that film has been exposed, but before it has been chemically processed. The latent image is changed into a manifest image or the radiographic image after the film has been processed. The specific way in which the latent image is formed is explained by Gurney-Mott theory of latent image formation. This particular picture explains how a latent image is formed and has been explained by the Gurney-Mott theory. A film has typical characteristics. The film speed, contrast and latitude are the three most important characteristics of a radiographic film. A plot of the optical density as a function of the logarithm of the exposure is called the characteristic curve, sensitometric curve or an HND, Herter and Driffield curve. The precise shape of the curve depends on the quality of the X-ray beam used for exposure, characteristics of the emulsion and the processing conditions. The primary use of the curve is to describe the contrast characteristics of the film throughout a wide exposure range. This curve shown in the figure is the characteristic curves and is shown what are the different regions on the curve. Now, as mentioned, the curve has four regions. The lowest one is the base plus fog region, followed by the toe region, straight line portion and the shoulder region. Dmax represents the maximum density of the film that it is capable of recording. The base plus fog region represents the inherent density or the initial film density before exposure to X-ray photons. The toe is the low exposure region and the shoulder is the high exposure region of the curve. The optical density in the toe region ranges from 0.2 to 0.5. The region in between the toe and the shoulder is known as the linear region. The shoulder region represents the area of high exposure levels. The optical density in the shoulder region is more than 2.5. A radiograph with optical densities in the region of the toe or shoulder furnishes an image with inferior contrast. Now, what is meant by film contrast? It is the difference in optical density between two areas in the image. Films with exposures between optical density 0.5 and 2.5 exhibit contrast in the diagnostic range. Films with optical density in the toe or shoulder portion of the characteristic curve demonstrate a loss of contrast, whereas the films with steeper straight line portions have higher contrast. The other term that is used to characterize the film is latitude. Latitude is the exposure range over which acceptable optical densities are produced. Films can have wide or narrow latitude. Latitude and contrast are inversely related, meaning that as contrast increases, latitude decreases. This figure shows the characteristic curves of lines having different latitude. Another characteristic of the film is its gradient. The radiation exposure to an X-ray film should be sufficient to place the range of optical densities exhibited by the processed film along the essentially straight line portion of the characteristic curve. The average slope of this portion of the curve is referred to as the average gradient of the film. The formula for the average gradient is the difference in the optical density values at two different values of the exposure. Often the D1 and D2 values as shown in the curve are taken as optical densities of 0.3 and 2 respectively. Films with higher average gradients tend to furnish images with higher contrast, that is more blacks and whites and fewer shades of grey, then do films with lower values of the average gradient. Another term used to characterize the film is the gamma. The maximum value of the slope of the characteristic curve is termed the gamma of the film. The gamma of a film may be defined explicitly as the slope at the inflection point of the characteristic curve. The film speed or film sensitivity describe the ability of an X-ray film to respond to an X-ray exposure. It is a measure of the position of the characteristic curve at a specific value of the exposure axis. The toe of the HND curve is short for high speed or the fast film and longer for film with lower speed or the slow film. The speed point of a film describes the exposure required to produce an optical density of 1 above base. A faster film requires less exposure and lower MAS setting to produce the same optical density. Larger crystal size with increased numbers of sensitivity specks suspended in a thick emulsion all increase the speed of the film. So, the film speed is defined as the reciprocal of exposure in Röntgen required for an optical density of 1 above base density. Now, we need to understand the concept of sensitometry and the quality control of the film. Sensitometry is the study of the relationship between the intensity of radiation exposure to the film and the amount of blackness produced after processing, which is called the density. It provides a method of evaluating the characteristics of film and the film screen combinations used in radiography. It is also a method of evaluating the performance of automatic film processors. Because automatic film processors affect a radiograph's density and contrast, the variability of their performance can be monitored by sensitometric methods. For the purpose of doing sensitometry, different equipments are needed. So, there are different sensitometric equipments. These are the pieces of equipment that are needed to evaluate the relationship between the intensity of radiation exposure and the density produced after processing. The radiographic film should be exposed to a range of radiation intensities to evaluate its response to low, middle, and high exposures. One of such equipments is a penetrometer. Penetrometer is a device that is constructed of uniform absorbers of increasing thicknesses, such as aluminium or tissue equivalent plastic. When radiographed, it produces a series of uniform densities that resemble a step wedge. The variability of the output of the equipment could affect the range of step wedge densities produced. A typical picture of a penetrometer is shown on the screen. Another equipment used for sensitometry is a sensitometer. Sensitometer is designed to produce consistent step wedge densities by eliminating the variability of the X-ray unit. It uses a controlled light source to expose an optical step wedge template. The step wedge template transmits light in varying intensities to expose the radiographic film. After the film has been processed, a density step wedge image, a sensitometric strip, is produced. Densitometer is also one of the sensitometric equipments that is used for the purpose of sensitometry. A densitometer measures the blackness or density of the step wedge increments in units of optical density. It compares the intensity of the light passing through a point on the film to 100% light transmission. Now, how do we perform quality control in radiography, or what is meant by quality control of film? The aim of quality control is to provide radiographs of consistent high quality. This can be achieved by performing quality control of the screen film system and photographic processor and acceptance testing of all components. Methods to reduce waste, recycle byproducts and reuse resources such as silver are also part of the quality control process. In the field of radiography, we must understand what is the safe light needed for the development of a film and what is the concept behind the dark room. Dark room is an essential part of a radiology department. The dark room entrance should be designed so that entry does not inadvertently expose films. Lightproof mazes, rotating doors, interlocks, and double entry doors are used to eliminate the possibility of exposure of an undeveloped film to light. The darkroom temperature and humidity must be controlled to avoid artifacts. Darkrooms do not have to be totally dark, but the light level must be very low. Safe lights provide low-level illumination without exposing the film. A safe light contains a low wattage, typically 7 to 15 watt light bulb with a special filter to maintain low light intensity. An amber filter is used with a blue sensitive film and a GBX filters that produce a deep red light. Red light from the GBX filter has low energy and is safe for green sensitive orthochromatic films. The safe light must be 4 feet from the work area to prevent safe light fogging of the film. A test can also be performed to determine the amount of safe light fogging. Half of a uniformly exposed but undeveloped film is covered with a piece of cardboard and the film is left on the darkroom table under the safe light for 2 minutes. The film is then developed in the usual way. After processing, the difference in the optical density between the covered and uncovered sides should be less than 0.05 optical density. One should have proper film viewing conditions in the radiology department. Proper viewing conditions are very important for interpreting a radiograph. The viewing conditions can enhance or degrade the subtle details of radiographs. The viewing area should be clean and free of distracting materials. Magnifying aids, masking aids, and film markers should be close at hand. Thin cotton gloves should be available and worn to prevent fingerprints on the radiograph. Ambient light levels should be low. The brightness of the surroundings should be about the same as the area of interest in the radiograph. Room illumination must be arranged so that there are no reflections from the surface of the film under examination. The view box illumination testing should be performed annually. The test is performed with a photometer which measures the light intensity at several areas of the view box. The intensity should not vary by more than plus minus 10%. If it is determined that the bulb is defective and needs to be replaced, all the bulbs should be replaced in the view box. Dry imaging cameras are also used in Department of Radiology. Dry imaging cameras were introduced in 1984 by a company 3M, followed by the launch of dry laser imager technology in 1995 by Imation. Termed as dry imaging devices, laser imagers, laser printers, direct digital imagers or hard copy cameras, they create multi-format images of digital radiology modalities. Fundamentally, hard copy devices are classified based on laser and non-laser technology. This figure shows the different types of hard copy devices and their classification. The laser-based devices are wet, dry, and laser-induced thermal technologies. The non-laser-based devices are divided into monitor-based, thermal print-based, and inkjet technologies. Thermal print head technologies are either direct or dry sublimation technologies. In practice, dry imaging camera are wide accepted, especially the direct thermal imaging and laser optic technologies. The development process of the films in a dry imaging camera is accomplished by heating a dry film. There are advantages of dry imaging camera. It includes that there is no wet processor required. It provides reduced maintenance and plumbing costs. It eliminates the requirement for chemicals, which reduces environmental pollution. So the chapter can now be summarized. So now we understand that what is meant by a medical film, what are its functions, what is the structure, and how is a latent image formed. Now we understand what are the different characteristics of the film, how can we characterize a film by understanding the different concepts of contrast, latitude, and the gradient. So I hope now we are in a better position to understand the topic, and this topic I am sure will be helpful to all of you in your future. Thank you.